Wow, Lauren, that was what I call a masterclass.
Thank you, Simon.
That's how you do it.
Heidi.
I think I can speak for everyone in this room, but you were giving us all the feels.
Ooh.
I mean, and you just sounded just so beautiful.
Mel B.
You have a voice that is just to die for, literally. I mean, you could sing absolutely anything, which is actually my point. Because I think if I was your mentor, I would have chosen a different song because you could have had everybody in this audience crying.
What, like Wannabe?
Howie, let's move on.
Good God, there's not much left in this.
Howie!
It's up to the audience. They can only pick one, but I loved it. America's gonna love it. You're amazing.
Thank you, Howie.
Lauren's fate now lies with the audience voters. One more time for Lauren Allred.
Stop. moto, nawaka. Ah ah, nawaka. O moto, nawaka. Ah ah, nawaka.
Yes.
That is a very good fun fact to know.
That's why I said
amazing.
Howie.
I gotta say that you are incredibly talented, you are incredibly joyful, but the guy with the headband, you're a superstar.
Yay!
Yeah! Heidi.
I love the vibe that you bring to the stage so much. All the faces of every single one of you. Mwah. Love.
Simon.
Mwah.
Well, there was, it's a lot of pressure, you know, when you're in this stage of the competition, and then to perform to your own song as well.
So good.
And I don't know what it was. There was a little magic potion in there because for me, this was just everything this show should be.
Give it up for Ghetto Kids!
Choked up every time when I see you perform. I know how much you want it. You are absolutely unbelievable.
Thank you, Heidi.
Unbelievable.
Thank you. Mel B.
I'm speechless. Honestly.
It's never happened.
Can I just say something?
Yeah.
I think this performance was in a league of its own. Genuinely. I mean, to do that, you know, without any stops, I mean, it was dangerous, it was brilliant, and it was, you just, your imagination and
you... Oh, come on!
Aiden Bryant from Heidi's dream team to her dream team. Aiden, how does this make you feel, man?
I've never gotten a golden buzzer before, so this was my night. I'm so blessed.
Mel B, what do you want to say to your new team, Mel?
I mean...
And your ex-friend.
I mean... I was literally speechless. And I think I still am. My golden buzzer says it all. You're just incredible.
Thank you, thank you.
You really are.
Heidi, how do you feel right now losing Aiden?
She's thrilled.
Obviously, I would love for you to still be on my team, but you're in the finale, and that's most important.
Yes, thank you so much for your mentoring. Thank you.
All right, make some noise one more time for Aiden Bryant.
But that was so cool.
Well, I know.
My feet, I could jump on this desk with excitement. You know, ever since we worked together, this group have so much talent, so much ambition.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Seriously, the crazy thing is, you know, you told me you feel like the underdogs in this competition. You know what? I have a feeling an underdog could win this year.
Yeah. Thank you.
Mel B!
Right, so I'm just going to say a few things. I did see a few things that timing-wise were a little bit off.
No.
And one of you lost the stick. I'm just saying, I see everything. Oh. But having said that, I'm actually really pissed at myself that I don't have the golden buzzer, because I would have given you it. Yeah, because your energy and your enthusiasm is off the charts.
Thank you.
It really is.
Thank you. Heidi.
Yes, the energy that you were giving today was extra. This was your best performance yet. Loved it.
Thank you so much.
Howie.
Out of all the acts that we have seen on this show, you seem to be the most in it to win it.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have the most energy, the most heart. That was amazing.
Right, listen, we came from nothing. We created this from the hearts, and I love these people so much. Thank y'all for these moments. Thank y'all so much.
Next stop, the finals, maybe. We'll find out tonight. Let's hear it for the Pack Drumline! Yes!
I wrote this song for my hero. Mom, this song is for you.
Cody, gosh, I got all emotional now. You wrote that song for your mum, obviously, and Tina, you are like a little lioness, aren't you? You really are. You've always been there by his side, and this is the second time, obviously, in a row, Cody's now singing his own material, which is a huge step up, and I am so proud of you.
Thank you so much.
Heidi.
I mean, what a beautiful love letter to your mother. Your appreciation. I mean, it doesn't get more heartfelt than what you've just done. It was beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Howie.
What a gift to AGT. What a gift to talent. Cody Lee, you are the biggest gift I have ever experienced on this stage. You know, I believe that everybody on my dream team has what it takes to make it to the end. But I can always use more.
Let me move over.
Cody.
Oh my God.
You're on Dream Team.
From Simon Cowell's dream team over to Howie's dream team, reluctantly. Right now, make a whole lot of noise for Golden Buzzer Cody Lee, who's going right to the finals.
One spot out
one
of
spot.
Eight.
Come with me, team.
The second Golden Buzzer tonight already. Man, this one's Spalett.
Whose team are you on?
Howie.
Whoa.
Heidi.
It was absolute perfection. I am jealous that she is on your dream team and not on mine. I mean, you are such an amazing athlete. You know, I love your imagination. It was beautiful.
Beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful.
Thanks so much.
Mel B.
The precision and how much time and energy and effort and rehearsal you had to put into that, because everything was perfect. You did yourself proud, your son proud. Well done.
Simon.
You know what? You sometimes think, I've seen everything, and then you see an act like that, and you go, no, I haven't seen everything, because every part of that, in my opinion, was perfection.
Thank you.
You gotta vote for her. Vote for her. Christy Ryle, the audience vote is enough to make the finals. We will find out later tonight. One more time for Christy Sellers.
AGT, now you know I can control playing cards. That's easy. It's even harder to control people and their perceptions. Howie, you took a big risk by betting on me to be part of your dream team. So tonight, I'm actually putting the finale in your hands.
Oh, no, you're taking a risk.
Let's see how you do, starting by shuffling these cards.
Okay.
I feel like we've hung out enough that you should have picked up a thing or two by now.
Yeah, look, watch okay. This. Look at this.
Oh, that's not bad.
Okay, that was pretty slick. Give it up for my beautiful assistant.
I'm beautiful.
Yeah. Great, we're gonna place the cards into the box so we can't tamper with them, and we'll get back to them later.
Okay.
Because we're all gonna play a game together, okay? But we do need something to gamble with. I don't think he noticed just yet, but I actually bumped into Terry earlier.
Oh.
And borrowed his wallet.
I borrowed it.
I taught you how to do this last time. Terry, we just needed to borrow some cash. One, two, three. You don't carry much cash, do you?
No.
But Howie, can you wave your hands and place it over the bills, please?
Wave my hand?
On top, yeah.
Okay.
Over the ones.
Okay.
See, I think everything you touch turns into gold.
Oh, oh.
Lift up your hands.
Ooh.
No.
Hundreds.
I want to do that.
Now we have more money to play with.
Wow.
Mel, you're up close.
Yeah.
We're going to play a little game, but the audience tonight can help you. This
okay.
is an observation game.
Right.
Okay, so don't let me distract you. Focus closely. Ready?
Yeah. Right.
How many cards were there?
Oh, I didn't know I had to count them.
You guys can help her out, okay? It was a royal flush.
Five.
You're correct, okay? What color were the backs?
Red.
Okay.
Red.
Good. Simon looks so worried for you. No. She's doing better than the last one. So I think you might have missed it because this was all merely a suggestion.
They're blue.
Because they were blue the whole time. And you might have missed it because the cars never even existed. I want you to have another chance. You know, they say the best way not to lose your money is to hold on to it tight. So here, just take a bill. Yep.
All of them.
And just take one of them. I'm going to take the 100.
Right.
So fold it in front of you. Okay. Fold it in half again. Yes, and fold it down. Yes, good. Hold out your hand flat, like a table. I'm gonna place both bills into your hand, squeeze tightly. Turn it over. I'm gonna reach in, we're gonna play another game.
Right.
Whichever one I don't get, you get to keep.
Right.
Okay. Don't look just yet. Ready? Don't look.
Right.
Which one do you think you got?
20.
I don't think that was one of the options.
It was a 1 or 100.
Oh, it was?
It was a 1 or 100.
It's okay. You're pretty.
You got a 20.
It's fine. I thought you got 20.
That's weird. I have a 1, which means what do you have?
100.
Okay, but again, I told you I can control people's perception, so watch closely. Don't move. Whoa. Now I have the 100. which means...
Look, the one.
Yeah, take a look, show everybody.
Open it.
So you just switched it. You've just done magic on it.
Now, every bill is special. You could have picked any one. What makes them unique is the serial number on the bill, which no one here could know, right? Right. And Howie, you actually shuffled these cards. Yeah. Can you take them out of the box? Mel, what is the first digit on your serial number?
Right, three.
Three. Wow, she can read.
Oh my God.
I'm sorry, I'm just kidding. Okay. Howie, take the first card and deal it face up and show everybody.
It what is a three.
Get? No way.
Next reader, keep reading it out loud.
Six.
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 Four.
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 Another four.
Four. Howie, I don't know how you're doing this.
Six. I'm amazing.
Six.
Six.
Wow.
Three.
There's another three.
Seven.
Seven.
Three.
Another three.
There's actually always a letter at the end of every serial number.
A.
A.
Show everybody an
A. It's an
A.
Ace.
That's good.
Thank you so much, Howie and Mel.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anna de Guzman.
I always pick the best assistants.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm not so sure about that.
I should have picked Heidi. I'm sorry. I'm just kidding. You're great. No, I'm just kidding.
No, Anna, shh.
Howie, what did you think?
Listen, you took a risk tonight. You took a big risk. She did a smaller, you know, illusion. And that was what was amazing.
Thank you.
Heidi, what did you think?
I don't know if I loved it this much today. I have to be honest with you. It was a lot of talking. And also some of the talking you said, I also didn't love so much. You know what you said to Mel, that kind of hurt me a little bit.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And I really, really like you, and that did not make me like you so much.
I thought we were both, like, joking with each other.
I think, to be fair, I think Anna was kidding around. However, I don't think you had the best assistant in the world with you. And then the reveal just didn't feel like that big reveal.
No.
Well, Mel, you were an assistant too.
Yeah.
You saw it up close. What do you think?
I mean, I really like you. And what I like about
you... I love you too. I hope you know I was joking.
No, I mean, that went over my head, that bit.
Good, because you know I love
you. I was
you.
Looking up at what you were doing, and it was really good.
Yeah.
So I think good for you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Anna's fate now lies with the audience voters. We will find out if she's going to be in the finals by the end of the show. One more time for Anna de Guzman.
I thought that was mean towards you.
I wasn't listening to it.
The pressure just got to me, and I got really intimidated by all the other championship acts that went before me. I hope I get another chance to show them what I have in the finals.
Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. Give me
class act. Your voice is just so beautiful, so soothing. I feel like Michael Bublé. I can listen to you 24/7.
Simon, what did you think?
I think, personally, I wish the track had been more exciting. For me, it was very... It was a bit loungy.
No.
Howie, what do you think?
I don't disagree with Simon. I gotta say, to be honest with you, only, you know, one act is gonna go through today besides the golden buzzer. This sounded like I was on a cruise, to be honest with you. This wasn't worth $250,000.
What?
It wasn't.
Mel?
I think you've got a great voice. I liked listening to you before because there was that obvious country. I think you have to stick to what you know best.
Why?
And that wasn't your best, unfortunately.
No, I disagree.
Make some noise for Ank Erdine.
His life. I mean, that's like, not for me. I'm gonna do these jokes.
Now you see how scary he is. You see how terrifying this
is. What are they
now.
Doing? What are they doing? Knife.
Tired. They should not do it.
We're gonna try again.
It's really hot.
so dangerous. Move away.
I wouldn't do it.
Crazy, man. Imagine one of them bites you.
That's crazy, right?
The Vardanian Brothers! Oh! Mel B, when you wheel your chair back into
this was so nerve-wracking! Oh, my gosh!
I feel sick. I feel physically sick. But you did it!
You did it!
Thank you very much. Thank you for water. It helped me.
The water helped. You know what? Sometimes when it doesn't go perfectly, and you say this all the time,
then
sometimes
you see
with
how
singers,
hard it is.
Then you see how tough it is, and you see, you know, and you didn't give up. And then you tried again. And then
I wish I had my golden buzzer right now. I really wish I did.
If at first you don't succeed, try again.
Now, Simon, you were up close, you saw this. What were you thinking?
I think you are completely and utterly nuts. And that's a compliment. But look, hats off to you because you carried on, giving yourselves a shot after that.
Thank you very much.
The audience voters will decide tonight if these guys will be in the finals. Right now, make some noise for the Vardanian Brothers.
I'm single, and I'm not super picky. I got a couple rules as far as age. I'm not dating under 26, because I need you to be damaged a little bit. And the highest I'm going is if I ask a woman her age, and she's like, you don't ask a woman her age. I'm like, that's too old for me. And my second rule is my booty can't be bigger than yours, which is probably why I'm single, because I don't know if y'all noticed, I got that thing on me. That's right, I got that dunk. Yeah, I knew I had a big booty when I was like 7. I sat down, I was still the same height. I said, oh, snap. Yeah, I got this from my mama. That's not true. My mom is the fastest person down the slip and slide. But I love my mom. She's great.
Wait a minute.
She's great. She's probably my favorite mom. If you don't got a mom, you gotta get you one. They're like dope, you know. But the trick is you gotta get one that likes you. Because I got a dad, I don't think he liked me. Yeah, because anytime I'm born, he just dips, you know? But my mom, she was there when I was born. And she was there when all my siblings, I got 3 siblings, and I'm the youngest, that's why I'm happy. Definitely can't be the oldest, you know? I did everything on my own. Nobody helped me. That's the oldest. And the middle child's like, hey, I'm alive, just in case if you need me. And then the youngest is like, hey. Why is everybody so uptight? Come on, come on. Yeah, by the way, I messed up again, but it's okay, mom forgives me. That's the youngest. But I need to hurry up and have kids before my eggs expire, especially because my mom, I feel like she treats me like a kid. You know, I love my mom, but she threw me a surprise SpongeBob SquarePants themed 29th birthday party. Nope, it's too late. too late. I don't want my mom throwing me a surprise birthday party. I almost rather my dad throw me a surprise birthday party, because that at least be a surprise. If, if he just showed up, who lives in a pineapple under the sea? You, apparently, where you been? My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
This man is one of the best comedians ever been on this show.
Preacher Lawson! Howie!
I'm just really upset.
Why?
Because I already used my golden buzzer. To be honest with you, I'm just proud.
Me too.
No other act is harder to do than somebody just bearing their soul, just bearing their sense of humor. No music, no fire, no nothing. It's just you and your mom's in the room.
What's up, mama?
Heidi.
I think you are the funniest comedian we've ever had.
Wow.
I really do.
Thank
you. I have always had a very hard time with comedians, but with you, I always laugh, and I love the jeggings.
Mel B.
Oh, you know I adore you, don't you?
I love you.
You know I do. I mean, I was just saying before you came out, I cannot wait to belly laugh. And you didn't disappoint. You had me smiling and laughing. Like, hysterically.
Thank you. Simon.
Preacher, you are just brilliant at what you do. I've never heard you repeat an act.
No, yeah.
It really shows for me that you've actually gone out on the road to build up a base, and that is hard work. And I've always thought something more is going to come your way. And maybe this is it, Preacher. Maybe this is your time, because you are so brilliant at what you do.
Thank you.
Preacher, the finals. Will it happen? We'll find out later. One more time for Preacher Lawson.
I really like this guy. He's really funny.